Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. So we are going to start the unit number 6, filters and attenuators. So according to PPP, we are going to start with the first point as a syllabus. So there are the two parts. One is the filters and second one is the attenuators. In filters, there will be the points, classification of filters, then characteristics of filters, that is characteristics of high pass filter, low pass filter, band pass filter and band stop filters. We will see one by one when we are going to learn the filters. Then constant K type filters. We are going to design the constant K type filters. The filters are low pass filter LPF, high pass filter HPF, band pass filter and band stop filter. So we are going to design the constant K type filters. In the university examination also, they are asking design a constant K type low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter and band stop. Next, M derived filter sections. If you are understanding the K type filters, you can easily understand the M derived filters. There will M means what? Modified. Small m means what? Modified. So if we are making changes in the K type, then it will give us the M derived filters. And only we are learning two filters, that is low pass filter and high pass filter, that is related to M derived filters. So next one, attenuators. So in attenuators, we are learning first point as a relationship between nipper and decibel. So these are the units of actually attenuation. Nipper and decibel, these are the two different units which represents the attenuation. Just a pressure la unit kiti asta, 3 to 4 units are there for measuring the pressure. One is the Pascal is there, one is the kg per meter cube like this, okay. One is the PSI. Okay, so there different units will be there which measures the attenuation. So design of T type, design of pi type and design of lattice attenuators are there in your syllabus. Okay, so in the university examination, each time there will be one question based on the attenuators and two questions based on the filters. So remember, minimum 3 questions and maximum 4 questions will come for 16 to 20 marks in the section 2, and 3 MCQ will be there based on this unit. So this unit will help a lot to get a passing marks for this subject. Okay, so we'll start with the next point, that will be the title of the chapter. What do you mean by the title? So title is filters and attenuators. So first of all, I will write the title, that is filters and attenuators. I already told what do you mean by filters, what do you mean by the attenuators. Filter is used to suppress unwanted band of frequencies while passing a required band of frequencies. Then attenuator is a device or is a equipment which attenuates the signal. So what do you mean by attenuation? Attenuation means reducing the strength of signal. Okay, it is exactly opposite to that of amplifier. Amplifier je kaam karto hai, it is exactly opposite attenuator karto. Okay, now title of the chapter we will see, filters and attenuators point wise. So first of all, we will talk about filters. So filters, it is a device or it is an equipment. It is a device oblique can K or circuit we can say. Which freely passes the desired band of frequencies while suppressing or rejecting all other band of frequencies. all other band of frequencies. Okay, so it is a definition, we can say definition of filters. So what is the application of filters? Filters are used for signals processing, okay, especially in case of communication. Signal processing in communication, that is radio communication, any television broadcasting, okay, or satellite communications. In image processing also filters are going to use. So number of applications are there for the filters. Only the filters, whatever we are going to learn, that will be designed with the help of passive elements. The filters may be designed with active elements. The filters may be designed with some mathematical models which used in image processing, signal processing, signals and systems like this. Okay, there will be different types of filters, but whatever we are going to learn for NTA subject, that all filters are designed with the help of passive elements. Okay, or we can say which is designed by RLC. Now next, second point, attenuators. So attenuators means what? It is a circuit or device. It is a circuit or device or equipment which reduces the strength of signal. Now strength means what? Specially amplitude. मग तो signal voltage असू देत, current signal असू देत, voltage signal असू देत, power signal असू देत, whatever, it reduces the amplitude. Okay, that is doing by the attenuators. So attenuators have number of applications, especially in function generator, which you are going to use in laboratory for the purpose of doing the practicals in ECAD, for the doing the practicals of ENTA, for the doing the practicals of communication. So function generator is one of the equipment in the laboratory. In that, there will be the option of attenuation. Okay, function generator. So similarly, you can use in a number of communication system where the signal needs to be attenuates. In CR also, you can attenuate the signal. So these are the two main applications of attenuators. So this is the meaning of title of this chapter. That is, what do you mean by filters and what do you mean by attenuators. On the next point will be the central idea of the chapter. So next point will be central idea of the chapter. So what we are going to learn in this chapter, that all comes under the central idea of the chapter. So according to syllabus point of view, we can write the central idea of the chapter. So this chapter is divided into two main parts. One is the filter and attenuators. So we are discussing first of all related to filters. What are the different types of filters? What are the applications? What are the characteristics? How we can design the constant K type filters? How we can design the M derived filters? So all we are going to learn under the concept of filters. Similarly, we are going to learn about the attenuators, that is resistive network. So the attenuators, there are the again three types, T type, pi type and lattice attenuator. We are going to derive some equations for the design of attenuators. We are going to design also. So all will come under the central idea of the chapter. So we can divide this chapter into two parts. So first one will be the filters. So remember this, all are the passive filters and attenuators. So two parts are there for this chapter. So in filters, what we are going to learn? we are going to learn the classification. So classification, which includes the low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass and band stop. Then we are going to learn the constant K type filters. So constant K type, HPF, LPF, band pass filter and band stop filter. Then after that we are going to learn M derived, that is modified M derived filters. In that we are going to learn LPF and HPF under the M derived. So applications we are always learning. Without application we cannot understand what is the use of the circuit or device or equipment which we are going to learn. So next, in the attenuators, what we are doing, we are first of all understanding what do you mean by attenuation, what do you mean by attenuation, then relationship between Napier and decibel, which is required for designing of attenuators. So for that, first of all, we have to understand the relationship between Napier and decibel. Then after that, we are going to learn the types of attenuators, that is design of T-type, Pi-type and lattice attenuators. And the last point, that is obviously the applications. So each having applications. Okay, so these are all about the central idea of this chapter, what we are going to learn particularly in this chapter. So next point will be the importance of this chapter, why we are going to learn, that comes under the importance of the chapter. So anybody can tell now the importance. Importance nothing means the applications. If we are learning something in the electronics field, that must have applications. Okay, so based on the application, we can say this device is important, this circuit is important, this concept is important. Understood? So application point of view, we can think and we can write under the importance of the chapter. So filters are mainly used. Filters are mainly used in the designing of or in the design of communication systems. So communication is the vast field. In the communication, television broadcasting, FM broadcasting, then there will be the satellite communication. Then there will be the, we can say, mobile communication, there will be the broadband communication. Okay, it will be the we can say computer communication. A vast field will be their communication system. In that, the filter is required for the purpose of selecting the particular brand of frequencies while eliminating the remaining frequencies. Okay, it may be type, again there will be the based on the application, there will be the different requirement. Sometimes we require the low pass filter, sometimes we will require high pass filter or band pass filter, like this. Okay. Now next, what is the use of this filter? What is the function of these filters? So the filters are used to transmit the frequency signal required or desired, we can say transmit desired band of frequencies, desired band of frequencies. Okay, so next one, for this we are going to learn or we are going to design for this the design of passive filters are important. So passive filter just requires the passive elements, which is of a small cost, very small cost. You can design the filter just with the help of resistor, inductor, capacitor, which is having very less cost. Okay. So, but the purpose we can get, we can transmit the particular band of frequencies. Now, next one, attenuators. The attenuators are used. In a communication system, we can say, for reducing the strength of signal, the attenuators have application mainly used in the we can say laboratory for the purpose of doing the practicals. We can design of passive attenuators. Passive attenuators means specially we can use the only resistors. Okay, only resistors we can use for the design of passive attenuators. So these all are coming under the importance of the chapter. Okay, wait 1 minute. Now the next point will be the as usual, what will be the recommended book or before this course objective, or sorry, objective or outcome of this chapter, objective oblique outcome of the chapter. So here there will be the first, we can write the objective, what we are going to learn. So first of all, as usual, we are understanding the concept of filters, and then we are going to design the various K-type, constant K-type filters. Okay, that comes under the design of objective, design of constant K-type, filters such as LPF, HPF, BPF, band pass filter, and band stop filter. Second objective will be the design of M derived filters, such as a low pass filter and high pass filter. Then third one will be the design of passive resistive, resistive attenuators such as T-type, pi-type, and lattice. Okay, these are three objective. Now outcome means CO number 6, that is the course outcome. So CO number 6 is the course outcome, that will be the design of passive filters and attenuators. So this will be the outcome that consider as a CO number 6. There are these 6 COs for this subject. So each unit having a different CO. So CO number 6 means 6 is denoting the number of unit, or we can say there will be the 6 COs for this unit, or sorry, for this subject. That will be 6th number will be design of passive filters and attenuators, and this is the course outcome of this particular chapter. Now last point in this triple P pattern, that will be the which book we can refer. So recommended book, that will be only one and one books I will write, but only one will be there, that is circuit and network. Circuit and Networks by A. Sudhakar and Shyam Mohan. A. Sudhakar and S. Shyam Mohan Palli. Shyam Mohan S. Palli. Okay. Now, this book is very useful, or all 100% syllabus of this unit you will get in this book. So you can refer only one book for this particular unit. So this is about the triple P pattern related to the unit number 6. All points we have covered. So can we start now the introduction part? It will hardly takes 10 minutes. Okay. So we'll start with the point of introduction. Under introduction, we will start this point. Introduction of this chapter, we can say. So in the introduction part, the first point will be, what do you mean by the filter? Definition of filter. Okay. So first of all, we will write the definition. Then we will see, what do you mean by pass band? What do you mean by stop band? Or transmission band, attenuation band? What is the cutoff frequency? What are the application of filters? And then we will come to the classification of filters. So all these points we will cover now. So filter, again I will repeat that definition. A filter, it is a reactive network. It is a reactive, which means reactive manjas kaya? It is consisting of passive elements such as R, L, C. So it is a reactive two-port network, or network you can say, which freely passes the desired band of frequencies, which freely passes the desired band of frequencies while suppressing or eliminating all other frequency bands. So this is the definition of filter. Now next, this filter, or these filters we can say, because we are going to learn different types of filters. These filters are constructed from purely reactive elements, that is L and C, in bracket I will write L and C, So these filters are constructed from purely reactive elements L and C because to get zero attenuation in pass band. So you can understand this meaning. What do you mean by zero attenuation when we are learning the characteristics of filter? So zero attenuation means signal you can pass as it is. the signal strength cannot reduce in the pass band. So there will be two different bands, pass band and stop band. So pass band means the band of frequencies which are going to pass. A stop band means, or attenuation band means, where the signal or frequency getting suppressed. Okay, you can understand the difference between stop band and pass band when we are going to learn the classification. So meanwhile, you can just understand zero attenuation means as it is signal or as it is frequencies are getting passed. Okay, so next point, what do you mean by pass band or attenuation band? Pass band / attenuation, transmission band. Pass band and transmission band, it is having same meaning, both are the same. So sometimes we can use the word pass band, sometimes we can use the word transmission band, but both are same. So the definition of pass band or transmission band is the filters which produces zero attenuation or no attenuation, which produces no attenuation or zero attenuation in the desired band of frequencies is called as pass band or transmission band. So definition is very important to understand the concept of filter. So pass band or transmission band means in which there will be the zero attenuation for the particular band of frequencies. So that band is called as pass band or transmission band. Now next definition will be stop band / attenuation band. Stop band / attenuation band. So exactly opposite here, the filters in which you can say now zero means, exactly opposite means complete attenuation or 100% attenuation. 100% attenuation in desired band of frequencies. Desired band of frequencies is called as stop band / attenuation band. So here the only two points are remaining. So the frequencies or definition of cutoff frequency. What do you mean by cutoff frequency? In low pass filter and high pass filter, there will be only one cutoff frequency. But in case of band pass and band stop, there are the two cutoff frequencies, upper and lower. So the cutoff frequency means what? The frequency which separates pass band and stop band. The frequency which separates the pass band and stop band is called as cutoff frequency of filter. Actually, if it is one, then it is denoted by fc. Okay, if these are the two, then it is denoted as f1 and f2. So now applications of filters. So as already we learned, or already we have pointed out in the importance of the chapter, in that we have written the applications. So filters are used especially in communication systems to filter the unwanted signal. Then in the telephonic circuit, that is under coming communication only, telephone circuit, then communication system consisting of radio communication, then satellite communication, broadband communication, television broadcasting, everything. Okay, so these are the introduction part of the filters. So in the next lecture we'll start the classification of filter and the characteristics of filter. Okay, so we will stop now.